Hello everyone, today I am going to say something about binary multiplier. Now binary multiplier is something, one circuit which multiplies binary numbers. So our input is binary number and this particular circuit will multiply them and produce the corresponding output. So we simply take one example of 2-bit number. So there are two numbers, each of them is 2-bit and they are multiplied. Now first we will see how if it is directly multiplied, and then we will construct a circuit which do the operation. Now suppose one number is A, another is B. So B is multiplied by A. So we have taken first B. So this is the number B. It has 2-bit. This is B0 and B1. So B0 is the LSB or least significant bit. B1 is the MSB or most significant bit. These two bit, B0 and B1, makes the number B. Next, we are having another number, that is A, that is also 2-bit. So first bit is A0 or LSB is A0, and the highest bit or MSB is A1. So these two number A and B, both is 2-bit. So we will now multiply this one. Now if we are doing multiplication, normal multiplication, so first we will do A0, B0, because first we will multiply with the number A0. First one is B0, second is B1. So first is A0, B0. So simply we can write A0, B0. Next, what we do? Multiply A0, B1. Normal multiplication, that is A0, B1. So this we see, this is simple multiplication, because as they are binary number, so binary number, this is 1-bit, this is 1-bit, so this is multiplication of 1-bit into 1-bit. So we can do simply logic operation for this one, that is it is a simple AND operation, that is multiply of two input, that is two input one output, AND operation can be done with this one. So this is A0 B0, this is A0 B1. Next, what we do? Normal multiplication. So our second term is A1. So first we do A1 with B0. So this is A1 B0. Second we do A1 with B1. So this is A1 B1. So now you see, this is the each multiplication output, individual multiplication output, and final output will be summation of this. So this will be as it is. So it is C0. So C0 equal to A0 B0. Our next is C1, next is C2, and if there is any carry generated, so this will go to C3. That means C0 equal to A0 B0, C1 equal to A1 B0 plus A0 B1, C2 equal to A1 B1, and obviously if previous carry is there, it will also be taken, and if in this case any carry is generated, that will go to C3. Now we will draw a simple circuit Now we say in our first row a0 is common because we are taking a0 for multiplication and we are multiplying a0 with first b0 then b1. So what we do, a0, this line we are taking, first multiplication is with b0, second multiplication is with b1. So this is first one is with b0, second one is with b1. Okay, so this is to AND gate and it will produce these two individual multiplication output. Now we see a0 b0, that is a0 multiplied by b0, that is this one, it is directly going to c0. So what we do, we simply convert it to c0, it is the output. Next, this output, you can see this is a0 b1, a0 and b1, this multiplication, this is added with another term a1 b0 and summation of these two is coming here, that is c1. So after c0 next will be c1, that is summation of this product. So what we do, we just simply take the next two product. For product we will take the AND gate and for our next series, that is this two term, a1 is the common. So a1 we take and a1 is multiplied first with b0, second with b1. So this is b0, this is b1 that we have taken in AND gate. This is b0, this is b1. Now c1 is the addition of these two. So okay, c1 we are taking addition of these two. So as there is no previous carry, only these two is being added, we can take half adder. So one half adder is taken here and the half adder sum, that is c1, because c1 is a0 b1 plus a1 b0. So you can see a0 b1 plus a1 b0, these two is added in the half adder and this is gone to c1. Now in this case, if any carry is generated, this will go to the next term. So what we are doing, if any carry is generated, that is going to next term and this next term is being added with a1 b1. So we can see a1 b1 is this one. So this is the a1 b1 and this is added with, if any carry is generated with c1. So if any carry is generated with c1, these two is added. Now as this is only 2, so we can make it a half adder. If we are having 3 input, then it is necessary to take full adder. But in this case it is 2, so we can take it as a half adder. So its first sum is C2, that is this one is C2. If any carry of this plus A1, B1, this is C2, and if any carry is this, it will go to C3. So its carry is the next number, that is C3. So this is 2 bit by 2 bit binary multiplier. The circuit, how it multiplies two number each 2 bit and every one is binary number by making AND gate and by making it with AND gate and half adder. This is the multiplier circuit. Next, we will learn another thing. That is decoder. So after binary multiplier, second one is decoder. Decoder is a circuit which decodes something. Now how the circuit is working, that I am explaining. This is decoder. So first let me take three input E, A, B. Now in this case E is the enable input, that means to work or not to work, the enable input will act. So to enable or disable the total circuit, this E input is necessary. Now first suppose we are taking E as 1. Now as per our circuit, if E is 1, the circuit will not work. If enable bit is 0, circuit will work. So that means if enable bit is 1, circuit should not work. At that time, whatever may be the value of A and B, whatever may be the value of A and B is not necessary because circuit will not work. So that's why I am taking a cross here, that is we don't care. Next thing is A and B is 2 bit, so it can has 4 combination, that is 00, 01, 10, 11. So let's write this 00, 01, 10, 11. And in this case, if we want to work the circuit, enable will be 0 in all the cases. Now this is a decoder. So what decoder does, it decodes something. So 2 bit, that is A and B, this 2 bit is decoding 4 line, because we can see in 2 bit 00011011 4 information is hidden. So how we can decode this 0123, that we can take. So suppose our output is D0, D1, D2, D3. Now we should do in such a way, when enable is 1, all the values will be 1. This is the example of active low. So if all is 1, that means nothing is active. So the circuit is disabled. Now 00, first combination is 0. So 0th line will be selected. So it is active low. So here it will be 0. All the other case it will be 1. It is active low circuit. Active low circuit means whenever there is 0, only that line will be chosen. So it is 0. So only D0 line will be chosen. So that means 0 is chosen and corresponding code you can see it is 00. So for 00, 0 is chosen. For that 01, 1 is chosen, or 1's line, that is D1, is chosen. It is 0 means it is active low circuit. So only D1 is active, other 3, D0, D2, D3 is inactive. Similarly for 10, it is 2. So that means 0 is at D2. Similarly for 11, that is 11 means this one is 1, this one is 2, so 11 means it is 3. So third line is chosen. Now we have to design a circuit which implements this truth table. Now we can see there is 4 line, so obviously our output will have 4, that is D0, D1, D2, D3. Next, this will be some combination of these 3 inputs. So here we can see for each one we have a particular combination. So in that case we can write or we can design it with some AND or NAND gate as per our choice, whatever we can do. Now here we can see we are using a active low circuit, so we can use NAND gate. So first we can take the 4 output. This is D0, next one is D1, next one is D2, and the last is D3. Now we can see whenever E is 1, all the outputs should have 1. Now we know that if any single input of any AND gate and AND gate is 0, the output will be 0. It does not matter whenever the other input, whatever may be the value of other input, it does not matter. So if any single input is 0, the product is 0, that means the output of AND gate is 0. That means if we use NAND gate, output will be 1. So we want 1, so that means we have to give 0. Now if E is 1, we have to give 0, that means we have to use a NOT gate, because E is 1, we have to give 0 to make the NAND gate all 1. So we simply take 1 input as E, we make it to a NOT gate and we simply pass it to all the gates, all the NAND gates, this is given as an input. Now you see, if the value of E is 1, that is in this case, if the value of E is 1, we are using a NOT gate. So this point will be E naught, that means it will be 0. So if 0 is given to all these gate, whatever may be the other inputs, AND will be 0 and NAND will be 1. So NAND will be all 1, that is this D0, D1, D2, D3. D0, D1, D2, D3, all the outputs will must be 1 if E is 1. Now if E is 0, so this will be 1, so this is going to be multiplied. So then the other input, whatever may be the other input, that determines whatever the output will be. Okay. Now we simply take now 00011011. So if it is 00, it is D0. If both the input is 0 and 0, only D0 is 0. So we can see if A and B both are 00, then D0 will be 0. So what we do, we take A and B, two lines, this is line A, this is line B. So we take one NOT gate here, and this is line A bar, this is line B bar. Now for 00, D0 is 0, so 00 means A bar B bar. So we do A bar B bar. So A bar B bar, if A and B is 00, A bar and B bar is 1 1, so that time after E, if both are 1 1, so all will be 1. So this output of AND gate is 1, so output of NAND gate is 0, so D0 will be 0. Similarly for D1, it is 0 1. So A is 0, that means A0 multiplied by B. A0 multiplied by B. So now we will take B. So this is D1. Now for D2, we can have whatever our input is, 1 0, that means A is 1, B is 0, so A is 1, so A is going as it is, B is 0, so B bar is going here, and D3, it is 1 1, so it is going A and B, 1 1. So whenever according to this combination 00011011, accordingly D0, D1, D2 and D3 will be active low. So this is how decoder works. Now we will take one simple example how this enable input can simplify, because this enable input can be used as another input, and how this affects the circuit, let us see that also. Suppose we are taking X, Y, Z, 3 input, a 3 cos 8 decoder. Output is D0 to D7 Now you can see, whenever we are having, suppose, 4 input, but how we can simplify this 4 input by using only 3 cross 8 decoder. So 3 cross 8 decoder will take only 3 input. Now suppose the 4 digit is WXYZ. So we are taking only XYZ as this 3 input, and for the 4 input truth table, at the first time the MSB is 0. If you take 4 bit truth table, MSB is initially 0 and finally MSB will be 1. Now whenever MSB is 0, that is for the case of starting digits like 0000, 0001, 0010, like that. That time MSB W is 0. So we are implementing this with a NOT gate. So it is 1. So 0 is transferred to 1 here, and this is goes to enable. So this decoder is enabled, and we are having D0 to D7 in our output. Now simply taking another 3 cos 8 decoder, next, whenever our MSB is 1, that is starting from 1000 up to 1111, that time W is 1 MSB. If this is 1, this is 0, so this decoder is not working. So D0 to D7 is disabled, and if this is 1, this lower decoder will work, and our 3 input, that is XYZ, this is X, this is Y, this is Z, this 3 input is given as it is to 3 to 8 decoder. The reason is the first one decodes from 1 and this one decodes from. Now you see, the MSB is 0 in this case, and the 3 digit is 000 to 111, and 0000 to 0111 is D0 to D7. So it is done by this decoder, and after this, that is 0111, next digit is 1000, next number is 1000. From here to 1111, in this case the MSB is 1, that means W is 1 and XYZ varies from 000 to 111. So in this case we can convert the 4 input truth table into 3 input truth table by taking the MSB up to this case in 0, for this case in 1, and we are simply using 3 cross 8 decoder. So this will have D0 to D7 output, this will have D8 to D15 output. This is with the help of enable input how we can convert 4 input decoder into 3 input decoder. So we have to use only 3 cross 8 decoder and we can have up to D0 to D15 all the outputs we can generate. Next is how we can implement any logical expression. Combinational logic implementation. This is the expression of full adder. Let me first write the expression. So you can see there are 3 input x, y, z. If we are taking a full adder circuit and if we write, we have seen in previous cases, if we write all the truth table, that is from 000 up to 111, if we write in which places for sum it is 1, the places are 1 2 4 7, and for which places the carry is 1, the places are 3 5 6 7. For example, the first place is 000, that is 0th place. You can see it is sum and carry, both are 00. Now if it is 001, output is 1, that means carry is 0, sum is 1. So you see the sum is 1 for the 1th place. So that is, this is 0th place, this is 1th place, so here it is 1. Now next is zero, 010. Here also carry is 0, sum is 1. Now you can see here also 0, 1, 2. For second place is also sum is 1. Next is 0, 1, 1. Here you can see both is 1. So it will have the sum as 0 and carry will be 1, because 1 plus 1, it is in decimal 1 plus 1 is 2, in binary that 2 is 1 0. So here you can see carry is 1. So you can see 0th place, 1st place, 2nd place, 3rd place. So for 3, carry is 1. So like that, in the total truth table, we are not doing the total truth table here because full adder we have already done. But total truth table, 3 input truth table of full adder, sum is high at the places 1, 2, 4, 7. Carry is high at the places of 3, 5, 6, 7. Now, we can implement this logic with a 3 cross 8 decoder. X, Y, Z is the 3 input. Now, Z is the LSB. So Z we can have 2 to the power 0, Y we have 2 to the power 1, and X we have 2 to the power 2. This is the 3 input, and 8 output is there because it is 3 cross 8 decoder. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 0 to 7 is the output. Now sum is 1 to 4 7, that means 1 2 4 and 7. This is sum. So sum is high at these places. So X, Y, Z is the 3 input, Z is the LSB, so 2 to the power 0, next is Y, 2 to the power 1, next is X, it is 2 to the power 2, 2 to the power 2, this is the 3 input, and obviously 3 cross 8 decoder 0 to 7 is the output. Now 1 to 4, 7 at this combination or at this places, the output is high for sum. So 1 to 4, 7 has taken as summed up by the OR gate, and that is taken into the sum. Next, carry is 3, 5, 6, 7. So we can simply take 3, 5, 6 and 7 summed up, and this is making the output carry. So this is a very simple way how we can convert any logical implementation. Only we have to know the truth table at which places the output is high, that we have to take in count, and simply only that numbers we have to take and we have to sum up in the output. For example, sum was for 1 to 4 7, so 1 to 4 7, these are summed up and this is the sum, and carry is 3 5 6 7, so 3 5 6 7, this 4 is odd and the carry is generated. So this is just one example, but any logical expression, whatever may be the logical expression, we can express the logical expression with help of decoder. The decoder should be in the order so that the input and output is in the order of that logical expression, but we can take any logical expression in this way. So this is the logical implementation of any truth table by decoder. Thank you.